This is Art Jonak, and we're here at the Woodward Estate, Chateau de Woodward, sitting in one of the many gardens. And today, as you can see, we're sitting here with Mr. Orrin Woodward, and we've got an exciting topic for you, one that we were talking about just briefly this morning. Mm-hmm. And one that I think, as you watch this, you know, dialogue, this discourse, this video, that you can implement immediately. Like, right. It's one of those absolute immediate ideas, and the topic is dreams versus drama. So, like, save the drama for your mama, focus on the dreams. How does that really work into your personal life? And then if you're looking at this as a network marketer, how does that affect your network marketing business and your organization? So thank you for being here with us.
Oh, you're welcome.
And let's talk about dreams versus drama.
Absolutely. You know, within community building, Art, as your community gets bigger, you're going to constantly have people that are having issues as they come into your team, because all of us have issues. But the people who win the biggest in networking figure out to put the focus, their time and energy, on expanding the dream, not expanding the drama. Right. And so naturally, we come in, if you look at a network marketer carrying a bucket of water and a bucket of gas, most of us run around, when we see some drama, we throw some gas on it, and then boom, we get a massive drama. Instead, if we see drama, we throw some water on that, calm that down. When we see someone that's starting to accomplish some dreams and starting to accomplish something, throw some gas on that and expand the dreams and minimize the drama. And those are the people that seem to win the biggest in network marketing.
Right. And we've got a lot of scenarios where we're watching, you know, the news, we're watching celebrity gossip, we're watching political gossip, and really, what is that filled with? That's filled with drama. I mean, most of it is drama. Look who did this. Look who's pregnant. Look who just got a divorce. Look who said something about
Absolutely.
This guy. And, well, I can't believe that politician did that. And so, from there to TV shows, to movie shows, to gossip at the office, the reality is drama's winning.
It's,
right?
It's really
so
winning.
So if drama's the tide, if drama's the, you know, the flow, if drama's the trend, it's pretty hard to go against the trend. So how do you do that? How do you personally do that, first of all? Focus on the dream more than the drama. And then let's talk about, how do we help people in the organization do that?
Well, I'm going to say something that's going to kind of sound crazy, because one of the first things I did is I shut off my TV. I stopped watching. It's like all the news, the CNN, all these different things, constantly negative news, or, you know, they want to focus on the drama, because it takes people, when people get wrapped up, sucked into that drama, that takes them off the focus of building their own dreams. So people love to get wrapped up into that, and they can be entertained to death on focusing on other people's drama. But really, your drama ought to be in chasing your dream. So what I realized is, I gotta stop focusing, watching soap operas, watching Melrose Place and 90210 were big. I remember when I used to watch TV, and I realized that's not helping me.
Right.
Watching other people's make-believe dramas is not helping me accomplish my dreams. You know, you get plenty of drama in the dream struggle victory in the process of chasing your dream. So any drama I'm gonna deal with is the drama of the battle, the fight for the victory in the dreams that Lori and I have set for ourselves.
So drama, it can creep into your life though. So how are you becoming aware? And first of all, I was gonna ask him, you know, so for example, what TV shows would have drama lately? And you probably would go back to Melrose Place, Hawaii Five-O.
I'm dating myself.
Yeah, the last time you turn on the TV. But if drama creeps into your life, is there a litmus test, a barometer that you can pick on very quickly and say, whoa, that's drama? Or how do you recognize that in your life? Because it is going to creep in.
It's huge. And so you got to check your own thinking constantly. As soon as I find my brain going through, I can't believe Art said that, or, well, why is Art doing that? And then I want to run over and talk to somebody else about an issue Art and I would have, for example. If I do that, then what I am is I'm expanding the drama.
Okay.
If I want to reduce that drama, pick up the phone and call Art and say, Art, my rule is, if I think twice about something, somebody's getting a phone call, because I want to say, look, instead of me expanding this, because I know my own brain can throw gas on a fire just as good as anybody,
right?
And the wrong type of fire and drama in that case. So I'm going to pick up the phone and throw some water on that and say, hey, Art, the other day when you said this, did you mean it? This is the way I took that. And 9 times out of 10, that immediately solves it because I was misreading something. And so we've got to focus our energy on minimizing the dramas so we can keep most, you only have so much mental energy.
Right.
And the more you spend it on maximizing dramas, by definition, you're minimizing your dream.
Okay, so you gotta decide which one. So
that's right.
Give me some examples of drama that doesn't look like drama. Like you can say, okay, I was talking with somebody and then all of a sudden you recognize that, oh, that's the crack in the door that could become a huge explosion. Do you have any, you know,
sure,
that you see
all
that
day long. You come into a meeting with your community, and so-and-so said something the other day that you didn't appreciate. So you're just, well, I'm just not going to talk to him today. Mm. And so now you think, well, I was busy over here. But you know in your heart that you purposely didn't come up there and say hi to him because they had offended your feelings. Well, now guess what happens? He's over there thinking at the, you know what? Art didn't come up and say hi to me, or Orrin didn't come up and say hi to me. And then if that person hasn't trained themselves, they'll start thinking about that and start magnifying that drama into their life. And the next thing you know, they go share it with a third person. Next thing you know, the whole team is mastering dramas, not mm-hmm. dreams.
Right.
So it's like be the leader is the one that says, you know what, we did have a tense moment or something. I'm going to go right over there, put my arms around her, tell them, man, Art, it's great seeing you, it's great to be here, how are things going? And that immediately dissolves a potential, just the smallest little thing, because you take a look at the biggest fire,
right?
The biggest forest fire is started with the smallest spark. Mm. And as long as we remember that, when do we want to handle that spark? When it's a little small spark, or when it's a raging fire?
We live in Texas, and when fires get out of control in Texas, I mean, it's a national issue. Their government says, oh, should we help out Texas? Because, I mean, it spreads like crazy.
Absolutely.
What I picked up on, though, is it's even less of a existing drama as much as the perception of a drama.
That's right.
There wasn't, maybe there wasn't even an issue. You were busy. We had to get up on stage. I walked right past that person. So has your internal antenna, become more attuned to potential drama, or you know, the perception of drama than before? Or is that a learned skill set for you?
It's an analysis. Like I will look at different team leaders and different people as they're growing, and if I say, does drama seem to surround them?
Mm-hmm.
Does it seem like every time I'm working with them, they have the next drama? Oh, it's their husband, it's their wife, it's their brother, it's their team, it's this. And I'm like, you know, some people are just not happy.
Right.
Unless they're unhappy. And after a while I realized, you know, I need to confront this if they're ready to hear it. If they're not, I just need to lovingly let them sit back a bit and go work with someone that's ready to focus more on dreams. Because I can spend copious amounts of time investing in people that love drama. And you know what I'm just going to do? I'm just going to pour more gas on the drama.
Mm-hmm.
Or I can spend time with people that want their dreams and help people accomplish. Then I can lift that person up that has accomplished the dream and say, this is what a person does when they master the dream, not the drama.
Right. So if you, you know, there's a saying, you know, the law of association, friends do what friends do. You said that many times, and I love that saying. Part of, you know, you read books on power or so forth, they say, don't associate with unlucky people. Don't associate with people that are unfortunate. Now that sounds very cutthroat, and that doesn't mean, you know, somebody's, you know, unfortunate due to outside circumstances. But the meaning of that is that a lot of people create their own misfortune.
Absolutely.
A lot of people create their own unluckiness. And you said, okay, if they're ready to hear it, how do you know that somebody's actually ready for you to sit down and say, hey, buddy, you know what? You've got a lot of drama in your life, and it's not serving you. You're creating unluckiness, and the reality is that people who want to have luck and fortune and prosperity in their life, they're going to disassociate from you because, in my opinion, unluckiness is more contagious than luckiness.
That's a great question.
It can happen. So how do you know that moment's right to intercede, to interject?
I would probably say Socratic method. I would ask questions, mm-hmm. because I wouldn't want to come, you know, it's like directly at them, I
right.
think. So, But I would ask him, I said, you know, okay, you're having a hard time paying your bills, your kids aren't talking to you, your husband and you are separate. Do we want to continue the status quo, or do we really want to make some changes?
Okay.
Because we've got to get, it's like when the pain of staying the same becomes so great, that's when most people will change. Either the pleasure associated with something or the pain associated, those are the two principles. And most people, if we were really look at it, we'd say most people change when the pain becomes great. So, okay, we've got this, we've got this, we've listed out three or four dramas going on in your life. Do we want to continue to magnify those dramas, or are we ready for change? Because if we want change, there are principles we can start applying. We can't make your husband come back. We can't make your kids start talking to us, but we can change ourselves and start to create a different us that can create different responses with other people. And at the end of the day, art can only focus on improving art.
Right.
Orrin can only improve on improving Orrin, focus on improving Orrin. So to me, it's like I can't make Lori better, but I can make Orrin better. And then in the process of making Orrin better, I can make the relationship with Lori better because I'm focusing on me, and vice versa with Lori. And so to me, if I ask that question, I get them say, you know what? I am. When people get sick and tired of being sick and tired, they're sick and tired of being part of the drama, wrapped up in gossip, wrapped up in this. I'm like, look, all that stuff happens to everybody. But winners, when drama happens to winners, they say, what can I do to pour some water on this? Oh, I poured water and they still want to have the drama. Then let them have their drama. I'm going to go over here and chase my dream with other people that want to accomplish their dream. And I've found that association makes or breaks you. I mean, to me, I'm going to associate with people that want their dreams, and I'm going to pour as much gas as I can on their dreams. And the crazy thing about networking, you help enough other people accomplish their goals and dreams, you accomplish your own goals and dreams.